following is a fan-based parody with no infringement intended. Doctor Who is property of the British Broadcasting Corporation. Please support the official release.
Ah? What? Listen here, you squiff. We ain't here looking for no insurance, and if you ever call us again, you're fucking dead.
Who is that, Amy?
Just those numpties at Churchill trying to get us to buy. Even in this vortex, there's no getting away from him.
Ooh, is it the actual dog? Can you get him to say, oh, yes, for our answering machine?
He says, sod off, you bearded crummock.
He really said that?
I may have been paraphrasing a little. What with me being from Scotland and all?
No. And all this time I thought you were just a little bit dim. Good to see you again, old friend. Oh, almost fell for that a second time.
Fell for what?
The old stink palm trick.
Must have taken you centuries to get rid of that ungodly stench last time. You walked right after tennis practice after all. Now then, now to business. I have something that I think you should look at.
Oh, is your gout playing up again, old Winnie? How many times do I have to tell you? Cut down on the roast beef and wine, or it's gonna get worse.
Confound it, Doctor, that's not what I meant. I want you to see our new secret weapon that will win us the war. Meet the head of our Ironsides project.
His name being...
Bracewell.
Why, does it sound dirty?
No, his name is Bracewell. Edwin Bracewell. Isn't that right, Professor?
Look, man, I'm here to infiltrate and kill you.
What was that?
Nothing.
Very well. Proceed with the demonstration.
Hang on a tick. I'd recognize that reused sound effect anywhere. Of course! You've got Delia Derbyshire hidden behind those sandbags. I wasn't that far off.
I am your sex slave!
Oh, for goodness sake, Nick. Will you stop ad-libbing and just stick to the script?
Sorry. It is difficult to resist.
So, you want to explain all this, who
is? Stop! Hammer time.
What in blood are you talking about?
You heard me. Give me a sledgehammer, so I can smash each one of these metal gits into oblivion.
And destroy a month's worth of research and development? Bollocks to that.
Amy, tell him.
Tell him what?
About the Daleks.
What are these Daleks you keep talking about, you fuck no good?
Oi! Mind your language, young lady. This is meant to be a family show. Now, are you seriously telling me that you don't remember the Daleks? A race of evil, unfeeling, genocidal monsters that invaded your world back in 2008? Or was it 2009? I really can't keep up with this bloody one-year-ahead rule.
You want to stop hovering by any chance?
Flying saucers leveling cities? Planets in the sky?
Listen, when you're out on a major roadsy on a Saturday night, you tend to see all kinds of weird shit in the sky.
What about Captain Jack and his fireproof coat? Or Billy Piper's fluctuating accent?
Don't you talk to me about accents. It's hard enough keeping up this ridiculous Scotch brogue. What is this? Rabsy Nesbit?
Would you care for some tea?
No.
Coffee?
No.
Cocoa?
No!
Horlicks?
Somebody call me?
Must. Relieve. Imply. Tension.
What's the matter, Bracewell? Need a hand? Not too soon?
Yes, Church. I think 3 seconds counts as too soon.
Lame joke. Tolerance level exceeded. We must return to the mothership.
Blimey. I better get after them. Amy, you stay here. It's too dangerous for you to come.
Ah, right. You're just gonna leave me in the middle of the Blitz. What if you end up dead? How am I gonna go home?
Call for a taxi.
What's that weird glowy thing on the wall?
Shh!
It is the Doctor! Exterminate!
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Is that a...
Oh yes, your one fatal weakness. A jammy dodger! It's a well-known fact that all Daleks are celiacs. Now back off! All right, exposition time. What are you Nazis on wheels up to now?
We are about to complete the next stage of our evolution. Activate the respraying chamber.
Respraying chamber? What is this? Extreme Makeover Planet Scarrow Edition?
Witness the birth of a new Dalek paradigm.
Hang on. Then what was the point of infiltrating the cabinet war room?
Gatiss was bored.
I can't go on no more. It was my good hand, strong hand, my one true friend, saw me through my lonely adolescence.
Bracewell, you're a robot.
Oh, you shut your trap, laddie. Robots go through adolescence too, you know.
Okay, so you won't be able to crack one off anymore. Big deal.
Good God, you wee cunny. Why do you think you're lowering your head to the barrel of a loaded revolver where you never taught gun safety?
Scotland in the 90s? We never learned anything else. Now, have you any bright ideas?
Well, there were those plot-convenient gravity bubbles the Daleks planted in my memories. We could send a squadron of Spitfires to attack the Dalek mothership.
That is without a doubt the stupidest idea I've ever heard. After the welfare state, that is.
All wings report in. Red 1 standing by. Red 2 standing by.
Red Ribbon Army standing by.
Red Rackham standing by.
Red Grant standing by.
Pokemon Red standing by.
Cushing gonna come out of that chamber next?
We are the new Dalek race, and those drab colours have simply got to go. All hail the...
No, wait. Let me guess. The United Daleks of Benetton? Nope. The Dalek Pride Movement? Mighty Morphin Dalek Rangers? I could do this all day. I mean, come on. What's the point of all this?
To win the war and look fabulous.
Oh, really? I thought it was just some crass marketing ploy to manipulate fickle little kids into forcing their parents to buy the new range of Dalek action figures. 1,000 BBC Worldwide executives just punched the air. All right, old boys, let's show those metal bastards what we're made of! Tinfoil, apparently. Got any more bright ideas, Gatiss?
Well, perhaps if we were in a gravel quarry.
I'm sorry I asked.
Call off the attack, or we will destroy the Earth!
With your ship in ruins? How are you going to do that?
With Bracewell.
Ah, yes, Bracewell. Forgot about him. Another one of your robot duplicates, designed to infiltrate and kill?
Correct.
So that must mean the real Bracewell looks nothing like him. Plus, his voice is actually in sync. Anyway, how do you intend to destroy the world with him? He's only got one hand, for goodness sake!
Bracewell is a bomb!
Bracewell is a bomb?
Bracewell is a bomb!
Bracewell is a bomb!
Oh, Bracewell is a bomb,
Bracewell is a bomb? A bomb? A bomb? Bracewell is a bomb.
At Bracewell is a bomb.
Bracewell is a bomb.
Bracewell is a bomb.
Bracewell is a bomb!
Bracewell is a bomb?
Bracewell is a bomb?
Bracewell is a bomb?
Bracewell is a vampire! I mean bomb. A bomb! Oh, come on. This is my own damn show. Let me have this little moment, won't you?
At this rate, I should start charging you rent on my jokes.
My God, man, why'd you do that?
Bracewell is a bomb!
Bracewell is a bomb?
Yes, he is! So that's how you make it stop. And not just any bomb, he's a sex bomb!
Steady now, Doctor.
No, I mean a literal sex bomb. Any form of sexual excitement will trigger it, and the entire planet will be kaput. Listen, Bracewell, can you hear me? You must not think any erotic thoughts whatsoever.
But I can't help it, Doctor. I can't take my eyes off those little leggies. They go on forever. Yes, they do.
My chips aren't too bad either.
Amy, you're not helping. Now cover up those legs before this man goes off.
Don't you say, young lady. I just had this floor mopped.
Sorry, guys. I haven't been able to cover up my legs since 9/11. Too soon?
Worse than that. About 60 years too early. Come on, Bracewell. Just put those grand, majestic legs out of your mind. Not easy, I know, but you must try. Oh, I've got it. This usually does the trick. Think of Margaret Thatcher naked on a cold day.
I don't know what that is.
Damn, again too early. Okay, Oh, what about the Prime Minister in the room with us right now? Think of Winston back there. Picture him wearing a saucy black negligee.
Yeah, that was a gift from my wife. I never secretly parade up and down in front of the bedroom mirror wearing it while she was out of the house. I said too much.
Phew!
Can someone please pass me the brain bleach now?
Activate the time corridor.
But it only goes one way. There will be no return.
Activate. Identify present location.
City of London. Year 1984.
Explain. Explain. Oh, won't you explain?
Time corridor needs work.
Well, this is awkward.
Welcome to my Dalek poetry reading. This one is called Daffodils.